MuseScore Studio is notation software that's completely free and it's great for creating scores, but it can sometimes be hard to work out how to create less common notation layouts. Hi, it's Katie here from Midnight Music, and in this video, I'll show you how to create a score that has multiple short pieces on a single page, and you'll be able to use the same steps to create pages of exercises, scales, or warm-ups. Here's where we're going to end up, a single page score that has three short pieces on it, one after the other. The secret here is that this is just a single instrument stave that has been formatted in a specific way to make it look like three separate pieces. Let's run through the steps. Here's my first piece. I won't be covering note entry methods in this video, but if you need help with that, I'll link a couple of useful tutorials in the description box below. We'll start by adding a final bar line at the end of this piece. Select the final measure and then go to the bar lines palette and click on final bar line. Next, we want to push the remaining measures down to the next line. With the final measure still selected, go to the layout palette and click on section break. The rest of the measures will be pushed down to the next system. The sign here indicates that a section break has been added to the score and it won't show when you print. You can hide or show these formatting marks while you work. Press Escape to deselect the measure and then go to Properties and click on the eye next to Formatting. I'll turn it back on for this tutorial. Now you can add the key signature and time signature of your second piece. Select the first measure in Song 2, go back to the palettes, click on Key Signatures and choose the one you need. With the measure still selected, go to the Time Signatures palette and click on the time signature for the second song. Next, I'll enter the notes. It's worthwhile taking a moment to point out that there are three break options in the layout palette. The first one is a system break, and although it might look like it has the same effect as the section break, the end result is quite different. If I replace my section break with a system break for a moment, you can see that MuseScore treats these two songs as if they are part of the same piece of music, and it adds in a cautionary time signature and key signature, and it continues on with the bar numbering. If this was one longer piece of music, you'd want those cautionary signs there to warn the player about the changes that are approaching. But because we're starting a completely new piece of music on the page, we don't need the cautionary time and key signatures to show, and we want the bar numbering to start from one again. If I go back to a section break, you can see that the cautionary signs are removed and the bar numbering is restarted in the second song. The third type of break is a page break, which is pretty self-explanatory and used at the end of a page. Something that MuseScore does automatically is to indent the first system of each song. Now, if you want to turn that off, go to Format, Style, and under the score settings, uncheck Enable Indentation on First System. I'll go ahead and enter a section break at the end of the second song. Next, I'll enter the new clef, key signature, time signature, and the notes for the third song. I have a number of empty bars at the end of my score, so to delete those, I'll go to Tools, Remove Empty Trailing Bars. Let's add the titles in for songs 2 and 3 and also adjust the spacing between the songs. To do that, we're going to add a vertical frame between the first and second songs. A vertical frame is a container where you can add text or images between systems in your score. Select the first measure of song 2, and then in the layout palette, click on vertical frame. Click on the frame, go to add, text, title, and type the title of the second song. Press escape when you finish typing. You can also right click on the frame, go to add, and choose title or one of the other options there. I'll do the same thing for the third song. Select the first measure of song 3, then click on vertical frame in the layout palette and add the title like before. Once the titles have been added, you can change their appearance if you need to. It's good to keep everything consistent, so I would suggest entering all the titles first and then adjusting them all at the same time. To do that, you can click on the first title and then hold down Control or Command if you're on a Mac and click on the other two titles. Then in the Properties panel, you can change the font, size, alignment, and position of the text. The next thing we can do is to adjust the way the measures are spread out within each song. You'll need to use your own judgment with the music you're writing, but in my example, I think it'll look better with the measures more evenly spaced out. Select the measure you want to have at the end of a system, go to the Layout palette, and this time we'll click on System Break. You can also use the shortcut Enter or Return. Repeat this for the other songs. Spacing out the measures like this also means that they end up filling the full width of a system. One final tip, if you want to increase or decrease the space between the songs, you can drag the frame handle here. You can also go to the Properties panel and change the height, gap above, and gap below settings. And that's it. If you found this video useful, give it a like and don't forget to subscribe so that you don't miss any future videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.